It's only appropriate that his name Freedom Pier. Mayor James and City Council have been working very hard for the past 5 years to get this project off the ground. This open space walkway is a Green Acres funded project in conjunction with financial help of the Economic Development Association, the Delaware River Port Authority, and the city's Urban Development Action Grant Program. This will ensure public access to this beautiful pier for the current and future generations to come. It's long overdue for the residents of Gloucester City to be able to enjoy this city's own land border, the Delaware River. Mayor James could not be here today due to a previous engagement, but he asked that I read this on his behalf. Because of a previous engagement, I am unable to be with you today on this special occasion. The renovation and reconstruction of Freedom Pier has been a long time coming. The innovative ideas and teamwork has made this project a success. Several years ago, the price tag for this project was $3.8 million and was put on the back burner. Using a construction design and engineering along with a good project manager that is a Gloucester City resident, we were able to complete the project for $1 million. The reconstruction of the pier was funded by the state and the DRPA and an economic development grant. The walkway project was funded 50% by the New Jersey State Green Acres and 50% UDAG grant. We are now confident and ready for the construction of a restaurant and a future retail location on this site. Today, September 17th, 2011, I declare that Freedom Pier is now open to the public. Enjoy this additional 1,200-foot scenic walkway along the Delaware River and have a great day. Mayor William James. I'd like to now ask that Deacon Frank Crossan come up and say a prayer and give the blessing to the pier.
Good morning. It's an honor to be here, being born and raised in this city. For the past 70 years I've been here. And I'm honored because I do know that my great-grandparents got off here. They immigrated here and came through this city and settled in Philadelphia. So I'm honored to read this prayer for Father that he had written for me. I did not write it, but he did, and he's being an old Irishman. He knows what he's doing. Dear God, you are the creator of all things. You created the sky, the sun, the moon, and the stars. You created the earth, the great land masses of the continents, the mighty oceans and the great rivers. You created this Delaware River that flows from the mountains in New York to the great Delaware Bay. It has been such a source of life wherever it touches. It has been the great center of much that has happened in this historic town.
The Delaware River. Mayor James.
It has been the center of trade and recreation down through the centuries. We stand on the banks of the great Delaware River.
Sweet America, you know, God done shed his grace on thee. He crowned America. Yes, he did.
Services. He's also been the president of the South Jersey AFL-CIO. He's been very helpful and supportive of us on this project and in acquiring many grants from the state here in Gloucester City. Please welcome my friend, our friend, the Honorable Donald Norcross.
Thank you very much for that introduction. But what I'm most proud of is representing you. Your voice going to Trenton, fighting for the very things that we're sitting here today. Whether it's from the north to Camden City, all the way down through National Park, we're blessed with having one of the greatest economic development tools in our country. It's called the Delaware River, right behind us. When we take a look at what they're doing here in Gloucester City, in a name of a pier that couldn't be any better, particularly after coming off last weekend in the events of 9/11, I would guess that this pier was the, as I call it, the mini Ellis Island for many of our parents, grandparents, great-grandparents who came to this country. And although we've seen our area change from a high-density industrial port, we now have to make way for the new jobs of the future. Because what we're looking at here today, although it's good economic development, it's about jobs. It's about redeveloping our waterfronts, making it ready for the upcoming century so that folks, our children, can enjoy this, our grandchildren, and will always remember it as that gateway to America. We take a look behind us, the walkway. You know, access to the riverfront. That's a great economic development tool because men and women want to come here. My assembly running mates, Angel Fuentes and Whip Wilson, understand that jobs is the number one thing that we have to do here. But we're in a bureaucracy. I'm not going to kid anybody and say it's going on. There's rules, there's regulations. Many of them are way too difficult. But many of them are here for a good reason. We don't want to put people in harm's way. So what I have to really take my hat off to is to the mayor and council, what they've been able to do to find that area, to fix it, to clean it up, and make it ready for the next upcoming developments that are coming here. I understand you're going to hear about some of those very shortly. But on behalf of our team, Your Voice in Trenton, I want to thank you for the support that you've given to mayor and council and to redevelopment so that we can get more jobs for here in South Jersey, particularly in Gloucester City. Thank you very much and have a good weekend.
The other night when we had the wine and cheese, see the tent over there? We had 10 people holding that up during the wine and cheese party. One of the other things that we are doing, it's very, very interesting, is that, you know, over the last 15 years, again, there's been plans here by architects, by, you know, engineers. It's frustrating. We had $1.5 million worth of plans, I think, on the second floor of the municipal building. So when this administration came in, they said, let's start putting a shovel on the ground. Let's start doing something. Do something even if it's wrong. So I give them a lot of credit as it relates to coming up with a plan with the walkway, all right, with the public access. One of the other controversial, and I bring it, you know, I'm an open pipe guy. One of the other controversial things was the purchase of a schooner that was in bankruptcy over in Philadelphia. To this date, it's probably been one of our best promotional assets of the city. We've been to 25 different communities around the Delaware River. We've had at least 1,000 kids on educational cruises for the last 2 years, and we've had 25 charters. By the way, you can see that the schooner Northwind is not in its berth today. It is in Essington, Pennsylvania, not only chartered for the day at $1,000, but didn't try here. But also, it's bringing the word to all the other people that Gloucester City's ready to go. A little later on, we're going to have a special announcement, little down the line, which is going to be very exciting. One of the other things that we're going to do, you see that ugly building over there, guys?
Yeah.
To the north? We're having everybody involved with this project. The city art class is going to be putting the history of Gloucester City's waterfront on that in a period of 2 years. It's going to be done in phases, and that'll eliminate that ugly building over there. Also in the north, we have a old pier that'll be replaced. That's phase two. And phase three, again, we'll be talking about that a little later on. Like I say, thank you for coming.